Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Tech Throwback, where we take a trip down memory lane with some old school products. I'm your host Kevin, and today we'll be taking a close look at one of Apple's portable media players. It's also the first Apple product I've ever owned, so let's see how it's held up in the past 18 plus years. This is the iPod 4th generation. So the original iPod was first announced on October 23rd, 2001, and I remember Steve Jobs saying that famous slogan, 1,000 songs in your pocket. It was first sold on November 10th and it ended up selling about 450 million iPods worldwide before it was finally discontinued on May 10th, 2022. But this included other models like the iPod Shuffle, iPod Nano, and iPod Touch. The iPod I have here was released on July 19th, 2004. The iPod 4th generation had an 80 MHz processor with only 32 MB of RAM. These use a 1.8 inch hard drive to store media, and there were two models you can choose from, a 20 gig version or 40 gig. There was also a lithium ion battery that can last around 12 hours on a single charge. The starting price was $300, which is equivalent to $478 today. Okay, this is my original iPod and it looks a little dated. There are tons of scratches on it, especially on the back. The front of the iPod is this white plastic while the back is polished stainless steel. The height of the iPod is 4.1 inches tall, 2.4 inches wide, and 0.57 inches thick, and it weighs just 5.6 ounces. The 40GB model is slightly thicker at 0.69 inches and heavier at 6.2 ounces. On the top is a headphone jack, controller port, and a hole switch to prevent any accidental button presses while the iPod was in your pocket. The left and right sides have nothing, and on the bottom, there's that 30-pin connector. Fun fact, I was set on getting the iPod mini in blue, but my parents said to get the iPod instead since it's future-proof. It had 5 times the amount of storage and longer battery life, so why not? I'm surprised that my iPod is still in one piece without any major dents or gaps. Alright, the display is a 2-inch monochrome LCD with a resolution of 160 by 128. To put that in perspective, here's the iPhone 14 Pro Max with a 6.7 inch OLED display at 2796 by 1290. It was just black and white at the time that was backlit. Unfortunately, the hard drive is damaged so it can't boot up. Drop a like if you're interested in a video of me trying to restore it. I do have a working iPod 5th generation though. The UI is basically identical minus the color. It's cool to see how far tech has evolved. The bottom half of the iPod had the iconic click wheel. It was a touch-sensitive circle with 4 buttons that you can physically press. Menu, forward and back, and play pause. The center circle was also pressable. Pressable, was that even a real word? Anyways, it acted as a select button. All the buttons are very clicky, hence the name click wheel. Let me bring back the iPod 5th generation for a better demonstration. To move around the menu, you just drag your finger around the click wheel, clockwise to scroll down, and counterclockwise to scroll up. To select something, you just press the center button. And to go back to the previous menu, you press the menu button. The click wheel is one of Apple's revolutionary user interfaces along with the mouse and multi-touch. It wasn't an official name for the iPod's operating system like the ones we have today with macOS, iPadOS, or iOS. The OS was very simple back then since the iPod started out as a music player, but over time, Apple added pictures, videos, and even podcasts. There was no iTunes store or App Store. You had to use iTunes to sync your media. So there's a music section which looks very similar to the music app. Then there's photos and videos, which is pretty self-explanatory. We also have some extra goodies like clock, contacts, and calendar. Apple also included a few simple games. No Wild Rift or Pokemon Unite here. And finally, settings. You can modify some items like the brightness, EQ, and the clicker sound. With a simple design and user-friendly interface, it's no wonder the iPod was the best-selling portable music player. It's sad that the iPod was discontinued, but its spirit still lives on in other Apple products. Let me know what was your first iPod in the comments down below. Thanks for watching, and if you haven't already, please like, subscribe, and hit the bell so you'll be notified when I post new videos. And I'll catch you guys in the next episode of Tech Throwback. Bye!